how animals seem to relate to one another, and how do we fit in? I was house-sitting in the Sonoma Hills. It was in a very isolated place, and the woman who lived there had a project of feeding the deer. She had built a deer feeding stand, and every morning she would put food there, which the deer would then visit and chomp away to their heart's content. I was supposed to put the food out. I basically disapproved of the practice. I think it gave deer a wrong impression of what man basically has in mind for them, killing them. Anyway, I put the food out. Then I went indoors and I observed the deer behavior of the deer. There were about 10 of them, and they were basically divided into two parts. The chief division, the heftier ones, the well-to-do ones, approached first and made very sure that none of the lesser deer would get to the stand before they had had their fill. The other half of the deer lurked along the edges. Occasionally one would try to approach the stand but was immediately shoved aside. I started observing one deer. She started to approach the stand. They bullied her away, and then she started to behave in what I thought was the most disgusting fashion. She started groveling, if you can imagine, a deer groveling. She went down on her front legs and sort of writhed, twisting, groveling with her head back and forth, and sort of begging, oh, please take me, please like me, please let me in. And each time she would do it, she would get a couple of inches closer to the stand until eventually she was up there feeding with the big guys. Then I come along with my judgments. I'm finding her totally disgusting. How could she do such a thing? What about her pride? I bring all my human judgmental faculties to bear. Then I realize she's the cleverest of them all. She figured out what she had to do to get the food, and she did it, no problem. And then she was up there eating. I had to give her credit.